Good afternoon. Welcome and thank you for joining us to be part of this Mass. May is the month of Mary. I encourage all of you to please pray the rosary. We need strength from above during this crisis, and we have a powerful intercessor in Mary to get that heavenly help. Saint Padre Pio rightly said, Rosary is the weapon for these times. Wednesday, May 13th, we will be offering a lunchtime concert beginning at 12:30 p.m. They'll be streamed live on our Facebook page and available after on our YouTube channel. I'm immensely grateful for your great sacrifice and continued support for our parish. Congratulations and thank you to all the generous donors towards the Bishop's Appeal. Like every year, we made our goal this year too, all because of your sacrifice and generosity. Thank you. Today, this Mass is offered for all the mothers, grandmothers, godmothers, and all have taken the place of mothers, that God may bless you with His choicest blessings, good health and peace. And I pray for all mothers who have gone before us, that God may grant them eternal rest. I have no better way of saying how much I miss you seeing in the church. And so I repeat, while my arms can't reach each of you who are close to my heart, I hug you all in my prayers and in good thoughts. Once again, welcome and thank you for joining us in this worship.
This weekend, we honor our mothers, grandmothers, godmothers, and all who have been like mothers to us. Peter's words in today's second reading apply to many of them, for they have been the cornerstones in our lives, chosen and precious. In the gospel, Jesus teaches his disciples that he shows the way to his Father. Many of us were shown the way to faith by our mothers. Let us pray for them today.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
To participate worthily in this most holy Eucharist, let us acknowledge our sins.
Lord Jesus, you are the way that leads to freedom from the slavery of sin. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the truth that reveals the tender mercy of the Father. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the way that leads to the heavenly dwelling place. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Almighty ever-living God, constantly accomplish the Paschal mystery within us, that those you were pleased to make new in holy baptism may under your protective care bear much fruit and come to the joys of life eternal. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. As the number of disciples continued to grow, the Hellenists complained about the Hebrews because their widows were being neglected in the daily distribution. So the 12 called together the community of the disciples and said, "It is not right for us to neglect the word of God to serve at table. Brothers, select from among you 7 reputable men, filled with the Spirit and wisdom, whom we shall appoint to this task, whereas we shall devote ourselves to prayer and to the ministry of the word." The proposal was acceptable to the whole community, so they chose Stephen, a man filled with faith and the Holy Spirit, also Philip, Prochorus, Nicanor, Timon, Parmenas, and Nicholas of Antioch, a convert to Judaism. They presented these men to the apostles, who prayed and laid hands on them. The word of God continued to spread, and the number of the disciples in Jerusalem increased greatly. Even a large group of priests were becoming obedient to the faith. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Thank you.
to trust in the Lord. Praise from the upright is fitting. Give thanks to the Lord on the harp with the 10-string lyre, chant his praises. Lord, let your mercy be on us as we place our trust in you. Upright is the word of the Lord, and all his works are trustworthy. He loves justice and right. Of the kindness of the Lord, the earth is full. Lord, let your mercy be on us as we place our trust in you. See, the eyes of the Lord are upon those who fear him, upon those who hope for his kindness, to deliver them from the death and preserve them in spite of famine. Lord, let your mercy be on us as we place our trust in you.
A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, come to him, a living stone, rejected by human beings, but chosen and precious in the sight of God. And like living stones, let yourselves be built into a spiritual house, to be a holy priesthood, to offer spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For it says in Scripture, behold, I am laying a stone in Zion, a cornerstone, chosen and precious, and whoever believes in it shall not be put to shame. Therefore, its value is for you who have faith, but for those without faith, the stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone, a stone that will make people stumble and a rock that will make them fall. They stumble by disobeying the word, as is their destiny. You are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people of his own, so that you may announce the praises of him who called you out of the darkness into his wonderful light. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God. Have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way. Thomas said to him, Master, We do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, then you will also know my Father. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. Philip said to him, Master, show us the Father, and that will be enough for us. Jesus said to him, Have I been with you for so long a time, and you still do not know me, Philip? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, Show us the Father? Do you not believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? The words that I speak to you, I do not speak on my own. The Father who dwells in me is doing his works. Believe me that I am in the Father and the Father is in me, or else believe because of the works themselves. Amen, amen, I say to you. Whoever believes in me will do the works that I do, and will do greater ones than these, because I am going to the Father. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, let us reflect on three sentences in today's gospel. The first is this: Do not let your hearts be troubled. These are consoling words from the Lord. In fact, many things trouble us in life. Things weigh on our hearts, from little misunderstandings to great revelations, maybe a sickness, loss of a job, a suffering loved one, a friend in need, just to name a few. But Jesus tells us not to worry, because this life is passing and everything in it is a preparation for the next, where suffering will be no more. Jesus was speaking to the apostles who were troubled that he was leaving them. His words reassured them that he would always be with them through faith. He wants us to know the same, that he never leaves us alone. He knows all that we suffer and go through, and he cares. The second is, I will come back again and take you to myself. Jesus prepares a place for us, for where he is going, there are many dwelling places. That is quite a promise from our Lord, who assures us we will have a personal place particularly prepared for us. What an amazing love. It is quite a feeling to arrive at a place where someone has prepared with special details, knowing that we would enjoy them. And that is how the Lord loves us. And the third is this: How can we know the way? Thomas the Apostle asked Jesus a big question, which provides us with the answer from the Lord himself, who says, I am the way and the truth and the life. This clear answer from the Lord should serve us as a guiding principle in our lives. Thomas, a compass, beautifully said, Without the way, there is no going. Without the truth, there is no knowing. Without the life, there is no living. In other words, he says, without Jesus, there is no going. Without Jesus, there is no knowing. Without Jesus, there is no living. And that is why the good news is, when we are lost, Jesus is the way. When we are in darkness, Jesus is the light. When we are confused, Jesus reveals the truth. And so, let us take everything that is weighing in on our hearts or troubling us in life and bring it to the Lord to find light, truth, and guidance. And that is how we will grow in our spiritual life. This weekend, we are celebrating Mother's Day weekend. Motherhood is a very high calling. What relationship can ever replace the love of a mother? It is essential for mothers, grandmothers, godmothers, and all who took the place of mothers to realize that the faith, love, guidance, and influence they provide to their children and care in the family is distinct and invaluable. To be a true mother today is certainly a very challenging vocation. However, the yearly celebration of Mother's Day should motivate all mothers to understand the importance of their call to motherhood. Saint Therese of Lisieux beautifully said, "The loveliest masterpiece of the heart of God is the love of a mother." I repeat it. The loveliest masterpiece of the heart of God is the love of a mother. And so, dear brothers and sisters, let us be grateful for our mothers, loving them dearly, praying for them daily. Amen. Let us now profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth,
of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets.
I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. As people called by God, a chosen race, a royal priesthood, Let us present our needs to him with confidence.
For all of us baptized into Christ's church and the royal priesthood, may the Lord continue to increase our faith for the sake of his kingdom. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all in positions of authority, may God's grace enable them to lead with integrity, protecting life from conception through natural death. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For any who are struggling to believe and those whose faith is weak because of the current pandemic, may Christ speak to their troubled hearts and give them hope. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For mothers, grandmothers, godmothers, and expectant mothers, that they may know the value of their nurturing presence in the love of their families. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died this past week, especially Shirley Binder and Judy Candler, and those who have died from the coronavirus, and for those who are mourning the loss of someone dear to them, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the needs within our prayer boxes, the needs expressed through the prayer chain, and for those held within the silence of our hearts. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the intention of this Mass, including those for the members of St. Jude Parish, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray, say the prayer to St. Joseph.
Good St. Joseph,
as you led the Holy family,
watch over our families. Help our family and all families to know and share God's love. In our family relationships, may we find healing and seek to be holy. May our fathers help us to become faithful disciples of Jesus, who share our love for him. As foster father of Jesus, watch over all who serve as spiritual fathers. In a special way, bless our Holy Father, our Bishop, and our priests. May they follow your humble example in their fatherly care for the people of God, the Church. With Mary, you raised Jesus the High Priest. You know our needs for priests. Please raise up good and holy priests from our families to serve the peoples of our diocese. May our children and grandchildren hear and say yes to the call of Jesus, just as you and Mary did. Good St. Joseph, pray for us.
Mother of God, O
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know of your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, and the integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At that time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, David our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also, brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the risen Christ be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Amen.
Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ.
On this day, your beautiful mind.
Please pray the act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. We now have a special Mother's Day blessing. Lord God, as a mother gives life and nourishment to her children, so you give life and care for your church. Bless these women as we celebrate this day in their honor. May they be strengthened as Christian mothers. Let the example of their faith and love shine forth. Grant that we, their sons and daughters, may honor and appreciate them with a spirit of profound respect. May the example of Mary, Mother of Jesus, inspire them to live their vocation as Christian mothers and call their children to faith. Guide and protect them in challenging times, and help them to continue to trust in you all the days of their life. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Congratulations to you. We thank you, we love you, and we pray for you. Have a great weekend. Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.